Hey everybody, welcome to Down Home Backyard Gardening. Question for you, how many of y'all like figs or fig trees? And when you go to the big box stores, you just can't help but buying a fig tree and another fig tree and another fig tree. And you're just kind of tired of spending all that money. Well, in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how easy it is to create your own fig forest using the trees that you already have. Let's grow. So what am I talking about? I'm talking about taking a cutting from one tree, transplanting it into a pot, and then growing another tree from that cutting. This is a very simple process, but there are a few things you got to know about it first. Okay, so let me show you an example. 2 years ago, I made a video on this exact subject, and I'll put that original video right here. Now, it was 2 years ago, so don't beat me up. But I took a cutting from this brown turkey fig tree right here, and grew this tree right here. This tree put on fruit last year. I'm expecting more fruit this year also because there's even new growth on the plant. Keep in mind that when you are taking a cutting, you are actually going to cut the host tree, the tree you're taking a cutting from. So you're gonna want a really, really sharp knife. And let me show you what you're looking for in order to know whether or not that tree is actually a viable option for a cutting from it. So originally I was going to try to do a cutting from this tree. This is my oldest fig tree. This thing is 7 years old this year and it puts on fruit every year. But these are now dead. And this is where I was going to take the cuttings from. So looking at this fig tree, and this is a good healthy fig tree, lots of growth all over this thing. What we're gonna do is you're looking for a small branch coming off. Not a huge branch like this one, a small one. We could even go into that fig tree if we wanted to, but we're gonna look right here first. So you're gonna move the dirt away, or the soil away, and you wanna get down to where this branch meets the main branch. And already I'm seeing a lot of roots. See all the roots in here? That's what you want to see. We want to see a root system coming off of the branch that you're thinking about taking a cutting from. Okay, so this is a really good example. Of a branch that's actually not a viable option. There's no roots coming off of this branch. So we cannot use that one. That's all right. So hey, there's nothing wrong with that, but I'm keeping this in to show you. You want to make sure that you are investigating your tree to find a good, viable option. Okay, we're going to pull this pot out and check this one out. Okay, so this is the tree I'm going to check next. And look at that, it already has figs on it. So this is a very good, healthy tree. Hopefully, it'll have a viable option.
This would be a really good branch because of all the growth on it. So let's check it out. As long as it has roots growing off of it, we can use it. Seeing lots of roots. Actually, we're not going to use this one. We're going to use this one right here. Because if you see right there, move that these leaves out of the way. Because if you see right here, this stem has all of these roots growing off of it. And that is exactly what we want.
Right before you start to do the cutting, what you're going to want to do is move all the soil away from the branch that you're going to cut off of the main tree so you can expose that entire connection. And you're going to use an incredibly sharp knife so you can do one nice surgical cut, limiting the damage to the tree or the cutting and the root system. Plus, you want to make sure you get your transplanted pot with good organic soil. And then you're ready to go, yo.
So without disturbing the roots, I've got as much pulled away as I can. Really good roots coming off this branch. So we are just going to, again, very, very sharp knife. We're going to go right against the main branch here. And we're just going to cut straight down. Just like that. Now, this could not have been planned any better. Look at all of the roots on that branch. That is perfect. Honestly, that's exactly what you want. And this one actually has more roots on this branch than the one that I transplanted 2 years ago. So this should really take. Okay, here's the pot. I'm gonna dust it with a little bone meal and blood meal. We're gonna get this thing planted in here nice and good. I'm gonna come back, y'all, and really put more soil in to really pack this in. And kind of lean it a little bit. And that's pretty much it.
Of course, the last thing to do is to water this plant in really good. Get it in the sun, not the direct sun, but get it to where it's getting some natural light. Y'all, it's really that simple. I just saved myself like $25 and I have a new fig tree. If you all are wanting to create your own fig forest, that is exactly how to do it.
Everyone, that's the video. And I know this is a short video because there's not a lot to this. It's a very, very simple process. You just really have to have a fig tree that is cooperating with you.
If y'all learned anything from this, if you got anything out of it, do me a favor, share the video, like the video, and of course, subscribe to this channel if you've not done so already. Everyone take care, God bless. I'll talk to y'all again real soon. Thank you.